Hey, how y'all doing out there in video land? This is Deletto coming at you from the Wild Wild West. Well, today, we got a little project. I'm going to take one of these and put some new OG goat scales on it. It's not going to be this one. This is my favorite 8010. It's been all polished. I love my 8010s. It's not gonna be that one. It's not gonna be this one because this one's already done. Not gonna be that one. I don't wanna do this one. Why? Because it's the original one. It's the one with the hollow grind. So I don't wanna do that one. This is my collector. Well, one left. And here it is. This is a newer type with the full flat ground blade. This is a Colt, this comes from the original Colt Steel Company, though. It's not a GSM Colt Steel knife. But I decided I'm gonna go ahead and do this one. Why? Because you can still get these. Not this one exactly, but you can still get them. All right, people. So let's go ahead and get busy. Set this one over here. Give myself a little workspace here. All right, we need a T6. And my T10 is kind of messed up, so I'm gonna use a T9. You should be using a T10 on it, but you can use a T9, it'll work too. Aha! Original goat, people. This came from original goat. And what do we got? Gun stock. The gun stock pattern. Original goat aluminum scales, gun stock. I have already previously polished these, people. I got these like last Friday and I polished them. And I was deciding which knife I wanted to use. I was going to do on this one because this would be an easy one to do because all the parts are chrome. I mean, not chrome, but polished already. And I thought I would just swap out the handles and have a polished one. But I decided I didn't want to do that because I really like this one. I like the original 8010 because I like the way it's made. I like these G10 handle scales. I like the aluminum liners. You know, there's everything about this knife I really like already. This one, you know, so I just polished it. This is the one I've been carrying for all this time, if I wanted to carry one. Let's make a new one. I'll set that aside. I'll set this aside, too. It's sort of in my way. All right. Aren't these scales beautiful? I polished them all out, inside and out, like I like to do. These are totally polished. And I thought I would just do polished scales on a stock knife and not polish the knife or the blade or the lock bar or anything. Or the backspacer, like I did this one. And so then you can see what it looks like with just a stock knife. This had polished scales and everything all swapped out on it. All right, let's go ahead and get busy on this one. T6. We're taking this one totally apart, so I'm going to take it all the way apart. Hope everybody's doing good out there. I've had this knife for a very long time, never used it. So it's always just been a collector. The only one I used was this one. This one's been out too now, but I still really haven't used it. I still really used the one that I originally used. I sort of did this one just to show that you could do a really nice knife for like $110. That one right there, that's the 8010 Light with the Tonto with the OG scales on it already. And that has the AUS 10A blade on it. I bought that one for like under $50, brand new. It was on sale. And the scale kit was like about $65 or something like that. And then I had a 20% discount. So the total cost of the knife was about $110 with tax. And I just want to show that you can make something really cool on a budget from Original Goat. When you put Original Goat scales on anything, it really elevates the knife. Okay, let's see if we get a part here. I don't know if I ever even had this one apart. Pretty sure I have. It's probably just been a long time. I don't know, it looks pretty fresh. I don't know if I ever had this one apart, people. This one looks new on the inside. This is different. What are these pieces for? So these are the screw-in pieces. Is that what's going on here? All right. This is a little bit weird. I don't know if I've ever had one like this before. I think my Tonto one's different. It's put together differently. Let me set that aside for right now. Actually, you know what? I can go ahead and put it on this one. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. Set this up first. Now this aluminum backspacer. I may polish it in the future, but I'm not gonna polish it right now. And now I just want to assemble it. Is that the right one? No, that's the wrong one. This is the right one. Yeah, screw hole right there. Let's cut that one in. That little plastic piece. Need this piece. I mean, not plastic, but metal piece for the pocket clip. It's like a little spacer. And my new one is different than this. The back spacer is different. The one that I polished, it doesn't have these little pieces that you need to screw into your back spacer. Little pieces of boogers. Okay, we got one started. That'll make it easier. Where that little booger go? So the pocket clip screws have this little stuff to deal with. Okay, we got that party started. We got that part started. Good to go. Okay, it's all downhill from here. Okay, let's get some lube out. I like to put a little bit of lube on my leaf spring, torsion spring, whatever you want to call it, lock bar spring. We got a stubborn one. Let's see if we can get it out. We're moving that scale around. There we go. Okay, I'm gonna put these scales away. So I always keep all my parts. Try to keep them organized. That doesn't always work out that way. Pivot in. Flat goes towards the front. Put my stop pin in. Now we can start putting all this stuff together. A little lube. Put my washer on first. My phosphorus bronze washer followed by the Teflon washer. Teflon washer goes against the phosphorus brown washer and the blade tang. A little drop of oil. Blade goes on next. All right, now we do this one. Another little drop of oil. Teflon washer goes on first, followed by the phosphorus brown washer. All right, now we're getting close to being done, people. Lock bar goes on next. All right. Now we just button it up. See what we got. Let me wipe it down first on the inside. We get fit together. What we got going on here? Something not fitting right. Everything looks right. Should just go together. There we go. Get in there, bugger. Okay, let's put the rest of the screws in and see what happens. It's a real tight fit on this one. Okay. Not quite all the way together yet. Okay, now let's see if we can adjust it. Doesn't feel like it's fitting together all the way. Let me take it apart again. Hopefully everything's, the holes and everything all right. Everything's lined up right. This, my 8010 is a little bit different from the modern ones. I hope that's not making a difference. The fitment might be slightly different. It's hard to take apart too. I could flip the pins around. Maybe that would make a difference. Let's try flipping the pins around. One stuck in here. See if I can pop it out. Makes me wonder if that was the right pin for that one. Maybe that's a problem. Yeah, booger gum. I thought this was going to be a fast one, people. It looks like it's not going to be a fast one. Have to figure something out. I'm going to check out the size of these pins. Make sure I'm putting them in the right places. Your thicker pin should be the one that goes in the front, the stop pin. Four point two two millimeters thick. Okay, let's see what this other one is. 4.72 millimeters thick. What was this one? 2.2. So this is a smaller one. So let's put this one in the back. I'm gonna put the bigger one in the front. See something that's happening here already. It's not going in all the way. Maybe that's the problem, is this hole. Maybe the hole's not big enough. All right. Now we go in and out a hole real easy. Why is this one giving me such a problem? There we go. Now we got all the way down. Okay, now let's see what we got. I'm wondering about this hole in the front, people. It feels like it's a little bit on the small side. Hopefully the rest of it will go together. Let's see what happens. Maybe they didn't ream that hole out big enough. All right. Where my pivot go? Put that down on the floor. Now there it is. Let's see what's going to happen right now. Pivot came out a little bit. Okay. Okay, now it snapped together. Okay. So it might have been this one not fitting right. Okay, now let's see what we got. I think it's going to go together now. Oh, we forgot to put the blade stop in. Gotta have that blade stop in. There we go. It's popping together now. Okay, now we got a tight blade. Okay. Well, that's a little bit of a bear to put together. I expect it to be easier than that. sometimes you run into some stuff. Just gotta deal with it. Sort of like life, it's not always perfect. I do all this in real time so you see what's really happening. Make sure all these are tight now. Just a touch tighter than finger tight, people. That's all I do. Gotta be careful with these little screws. You don't wanna get too overzealous with them. Okay, all the way down, and then back off, quarter of a turn. See what we got. Perfectly centered. All right. Perfect. Wasn't the easiest one to put together, people, but once I got it together, it's together. All right. Love it. Absolutely love it. All right, let's go ahead and put everything away. Absolutely love it. Yep, it wasn't the easiest one. That wasn't the hardest either. All right, the new edition. The new edition. The reason why I decided, one reason why I decided to do this one too, because I want to do some wood crafting with it. And I decided I want to use the full flat, it's a saber flat ground blade. Not exactly, it's a high flat ground. High saber flat ground. Oh yeah, it looks good. I will be taking this one to work tomorrow. You'll see my pocket check on it tomorrow at work. It feels lighter. Ooh. Ooh. Love it. I'm digging it. There it is there. So now I got a metal one of the Tantos and the metal one of the drop points. Those are my 8010s, people. These are my 8010s. This was the first one. This is the one that has the hollow grain. This is probably the most desirable one in a CTS. S35VN, I take it back. S35VN. I think it was CTS-XHP. Most of my old stuff is CTS-XHP. It's the hollow ground one. This is the original 8010 from Coldsville. I don't know why they stopped using the hollow ground. You know, I know a flat ground's more durable, though. So maybe they wanted to make it more heavy duty. Came out perfect. The only hard part was this pin right here. There was a stop pin. It didn't want to go in this hole. So I think the hole was just a little bit on the small side. But, you know, I forced it in there and it went in until it went flush. I pushed it in all the way until it went flush because, like, the pin has, like, a lip on it. And so once it's flat against the scale, then you know it's flush. You know everything's right. This looks good, people. Functions nicely too. Gun stock. S35BN. You know, I probably won't polish this backspacer. I sort of like the way that looks, just like the way it is. I think I'm going to leave this one just the way it is. You've seen the finished product here. No further modifications needed. Absolutely love it. My new one and my old favorite. This one has aluminum backspacer too. It's just not polished. This is how that's how this one originally looked too, before I removed all the finish on it and polished it all out. Absolutely love them, people. The 8010, in my opinion, is one of the best triad folders that Andrew Dimko ever designed for Cold Steel, or designed, period, for himself too. Because the 8010, if you don't know, was originally a Andrew Dimko custom knife before it came to Cold Steel. The 8010, the 4MAX, those were all Andrew Dimko knives before he released them to Cold Steel. They were Andrew Dimko custom knives. You were only able to get them from his custom shop. Same thing with the 8010, 8015. Yeah, the 8010, 8015, and the 8020 were all custom shop knives, if I'm not mistaken, before they were released. And the 8020, they made the 8020.5 from that, and they released it so it could be produced at an inexpensive price. That wasn't the Cold Steel though, but these right here were original Dimko knives, and then they were released through Cold Steel. He gave them permission to produce them. I'm sure he gets a kickback from them. You know, the 5MAX, the 4MAX, the 8010. The 8015, those were all Dimko knives. And then all the other knives are like a collaboration between Andrew Dimko and Lindsey Thompson, like the Espada, the Recons, the Tau Wars, the Counterpoints, the Voyagers. When I say the Voyagers, I'm talking about the Voyagers with the triad locks. That's basically what I'm talking about. All the knives I mentioned here are the ones with triad locks. Those were all Andrew Dimko designs. The Ultimate Hunter, the American Lawman, the AK-47, and others. People, I'm probably missing some too, but those are all like the original Dimko knives that he made for Cold Steel, and he co-designed them with Lindsey Thompson and the Frenzy too. I forgot about the Frenzy. And the Tylight 6, that was a Phil Boguszewski design. He's a very famous knife maker. He passed away in, like, I want to say like 2012 or 2013, somewhere around there, or, you know, a little bit in between 2010 and 2015, I think it is. He passed away. And he was the one that gave Cold Steel the permission to reproduce the Tylight. And that was his design. And you can still go to, like, like Arizona Knives or whatever it's called. I forget what they still sell Phil Boguszewski's knives, and they're like, you know, over, you know, all of them are like over $1,000. So that's one reason why I like the Tylight so much. A lot of people don't know about the Tylight 6's history. Tylight 6's history is a knife that was made by a famous knife maker, famous for his Tylight. I don't know if he called it a Tylight. I think he called it something else, but it looks just like a Tylight. If you go look at his old is custom knives, you'll see what I'm talking about. The knives, you know, they're all made out of titanium and stuff, you know, more expensive materials and stuff like that, but the design is the same. But I absolutely love these. The 8010 is one of my favorite knives from Cold Steel. The Andrew Dimko, you know, co-designed with Cold Steel, but he released a Cold Steel to reproduce. This is original Dimko design. It's not a collaboration between Lindsey Thompson and Andrew Dimko. This is a straight up Dimko design. Now with this blade type, I don't know about this blade type. I don't know if this is an Andrew Dimco blade or if it's something that GSM produced afterwards. I'm not exactly sure about how the Tonto blade came about, because when Andrew Dimco was with Cold Steel, they were just making these blades. They weren't making the Tonto. This came later. That's about all I got on these people. I'm gonna go ahead and put this one out. I am very happy the way that this came out. Functions perfectly. Absolutely love it. This was one I told you guys I was gonna make today. It was kind of a bear dealing with this front pin right here. That was a bear putting it all together. Everything went together smoothly except for this front pin. This front pin, I had to force it in because I think the hole was just a little bit too small for the pin size. But other than that, it's beautiful. It's a beautiful one, people. Absolutely love it. One thing I don't like about 8010 though is like when you release them, sometimes they bite you a little bit. So you gotta make sure you put your finger all the way up here at the top and not have it down here. Cause down here you won't get cut, but you will get like a little bite. You can feel it like a little bite right there. But if you put finger all the way up, you don't get bit. Absolutely love it. All right, people, that's it for this one. Peace out, Stiletto.